Andrew McCart, IFL TV. Oh, Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Newcastle, the home of Lewis Ritson. Yeah. How are you, buddy?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm very good. That's always good. Good to see you, mate.
I'm always good.
Talked about this fight, Robbie Davis Jr. I mean, I said to you in the last interview, you're probably one of the nicest guys I've ever met in boxing. You're so genuine, you're nice, you always say hello to me and whatnot. But this fight, it's changing you. I've not seen you call anyone the C-word before and stuff like that.
Yeah,
so it's,
no, you know, I shouldn't have done that on the C, but I lost myself. But then I've got myself. But it just, I think it's a bit rivalry, isn't it? I think it's good for the two. And it's got everyone talking. Like, I hear a lot of people say on the Twitter, it's fake. Be fair, believe me, it's not. You know, like, we're both generally dislike each other, and come fight night, we're probably going to see that.
Again, Robbie Davis Jr., he's fought up in here before, it's your hometown. The last time out you fought here, you lost the European title.
Yes.
Fight. You're not going to lose this fight, are you? A European title fight, no, in your home card for a second time, are you?
No, no chance. Well, it's not even for the European title, because he hasn't got it.
British,
yeah. Do you know what? I was just saying that in the interview, I'm an opponent. You know, like, the first time we come here against Highland, Josh Kelly was the main event. I was a co-main event, no pressure at all. Caught with a Patera fight, pressure a little bit too much. Sort of Jody Gloffin got in the head a little bit and trying to.
The weight as well.
Weight was killing. Yeah, but I'm not going to make excuses because Patera did box out your skin. And I don't even think I hit Patera clean in the full 12 rounds, to be fair, if you watch a fight, but I've never really. I've watched it back once now, half heartedly watched it like that. You know,
behind the pillow.
Behind the pillow, like, oh, kind of beautiful. But now I'm just an opponent, there's no pressure on me. You know, Robbie's the one that's shouting for world titles and on about this and that. He shouldn't be fighting me, so there's no pressure on me whatsoever, and I'm just going to go there and do my job.
What does, the needle that you've got with Robbie Davis Jr., does that add more fire in your belly? I mean, the last few fights have been respect with your opponents, but does this get you fired up a bit more?
Just every fight's a fight. I mean, I've had 100 amateur fights, I've had 21st pro fight. It just like, and Robbie was right what he said, when it's just me and him in there, and anyone's going to help with, you know, like, hopefully him not like, we'll make him stand there and have a bit of a go of us instead of trying to box, do you know what I mean? So that's
your style.
That's my style, that's the main thing we're going to take over. But I think Robbie's not that daft. I know he's going on about, he's a proper 140-pounder, this and that, but he'll get a shot when he feels our power. And no doubt he will be big compared to me, but, you know, we'll do plenty of spawn to figure that name. I'm looking forward to it.
British title, two-weight British champion.
Two-weight British title. I think it's for the British. I hope for the British online, two-weight British. You know, this will be my 10th fight on Sky. I feel like a veteran new on Sky.
You are, yeah.
So, do you know, like, when I'm only 25, when I first off boxing, if you said you were going to have 10 fights on Sky and be British champion and headline Newcastle a couple of times, I would have said four. So I'm just taking everything in my stride now. I'm not feeling any pressure anymore. And I'm looking forward to putting my performance.
Is it WBA eliminator as well? I mean,
yes.
140-pound division is...
It's red hot.
It's red hot. I mean, you've got...
Luckily, it's vacant. The WBA regular title.
Because Regis has got Regis program.
Yeah. I know he was shouting, I'm fighting Josh Taylor.
he can keep
shouting Josh Taylor. Do you know what I mean? Unless I get paid a load of money, Bobby, I wouldn't get anywhere near Josh Taylor.
Oh, really?
Well, it's money, isn't it? You've got to be wise. If you're going to fight for a world title, you don't want to fight the best of the bunch, do you? You know, like, and Josh Taylor to me is the best of the bunch. I mean, if they offer you good money, then I'll love Josh Taylor.
That's what I want. Call Josh Taylor out. Go. No, but what I'm saying is, like, it's an eliminator. I mean, you've done the British champion.
Yeah.
You fought for the European. You know what that's like. I mean, surely the ambition now is probably going to be the world level opponents, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, I know I boxed Patera. Out of a list of about 10 things, I was probably doing one right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, and I still only got beat on a split decision. Yes, I got beat, shouldn't have been a split, but it was first six rounds. I flew, really, to be fair, first five and a half. So, you know, we are that level, we're past the European level. When Oyo and Robbie won the European title, even though I thought Joe Hughes nicked it. So he's proved that he's past that level.
Mm-hmm.
So really, the next probably fight for it is the world title, so, or a world level opponent. So, no, I think it's a good fight. I just had a little bit to it and kind of wait for it.
Well, actually, we've talked about then, Regis Progray, Josh Taylor. Let's talk about it being a week after your fight.
Yes, in O2 London.
I've been looking.
So
have I, don't worry. Just give me your thoughts on that fight. I mean, you said Josh Taylor's the best at 140 in your eyes, but what's your thoughts on that fight against Regis?
It's a very hard fight. Like, mm-hmm. Don't get us wrong, but I think, you know, we've seen Josh, Victor Postol, you know, like, and his last report, I can't pronounce his name, but, you know, he was meant to have a really hard fight.
Baranchik, Ivan Baranchik.
And really, apart from that, you know, we've had the early onslaught, he pulled away, didn't he? So, I think he's proven that he's... he's the top dog for me. Like, and like I'm saying, you know, if I get past Robbie and offer a world title, and he's still got his world title.
Well, he might if he beats Regis, he has a WBA. You know what I mean?
Well, so Ed can offer me a lot money.
It's got to be seven figures, you're saying.
No, so, like I say, but we've got to get past Robbie first. Yeah, no. It's going to be a tough fight for the two. You know, I think we're going to both have to ask yourself each of our questions during the fight. But I think it's one that we can pull off and win.
Do you think you can stop him?
Oh, I think he's already been flattened his back before off somebody who doesn't hit nowhere near as hard as me. So it's always possible, but you've just got to hit them with the right shot, haven't you? And we think we can do that to Robbie, but no doubt Robbie will think that he can do that to us. So it's going to be a fun fight.
It's going to be a fun fight. And honestly, Lewis, I cannot wait for this. It's always a fun fight when you're involved.
Yeah, thank you very much.
I'll probably see you fight week, so
yes, you will.
Enjoy training camp, whatever it goes. And thanks to Lewis, 5L TV. Thanks very much, Lewis.